a lot of the time, you know, it's so like weird because I'm always like, oh my gosh, you know, you have like a whole office and everything. I literally run my business off my phone.
But that's a real thing.
You know, yeah, like that's a real thing. Yeah. Like I run my business off of my phone, like, off of my laptop. And
hello everybody, welcome to another episode of Say What. Now we know we've been away for a very long time, but now we're back, guys. Should we call this season two?
Let's call it season two, three if you want, because we've been gone that long.
Up to you. It's your favorite sister Jewel. Today we've got a very special guest on our show. Wow, guys, wow.
I'm so excited.
I'm proper fangirling, like proper fangirling for this girl.
I'm so excited. I don't know if I have enough English to carry me through, but you know what, I hope so.
Tell us what she does.
She's a digital entrepreneur and she is founder and creator of an amazing online platform called Hellen Rose, which focuses on amplifying the voice as a woman. If you know anything about me, if you know anything about us, that is what we are about. So we are so excited to get, you know, into her mind and hear her tell her story using her own words.
Okay, without wasting any more time, would you please come and join us on the couch? Guys, look at who we are!
Till the morning light. Yeah, I know they tight my hand, oh. So, baby, all of my property. All of my property. I give you.
And her handle is right there, guys, okay? Go and follow her right now. But right first, now. Finish watching this video. Oh,
thank you so much.
Welcome!
Thank you guys so much for having me.
Oh my god. Yeah. But now that she is here.
And so happy to be here.
Yeah. Is it your first time in Eswatini?
No, it's my second time. It's my second time here.
Okay.
And I want to come here for longer.
Yes!
Yeah, I'm always here for like a day.
Oh.
You know?
No, you're cheating.
I know, right?
So yeah, okay. Definitely, at least now you know you have a Swazi spot.
Yay!
So you can come with you guys. Sorry, I just want to make a disclaimer. I just looked at her and I'm so got snapped.
Okay, so we also have to tag the makeup artist, guys.
We're actually looking live.
Yes.
So we even contemplated conducting this interview with us off screen.
Because, yeah.
Hello.
Because when will your evil stepsisters ever? Cinderella in the middle looking snatched.
Shout out to Khosi.
Hi, girl.
She did that.
So maybe that should be our first question. Like, what made you want to seek out a face beat by Khosi?
Jeez, that's sweet.
Sorry, I promise you
this question. Okay, so I've followed her work, and happened to find out that she's from here, and then happened to find out that she's around while I'm around.
Yeah.
So I never miss an opportunity to get my face beaten.
Right. Because
I can never beat it to, like, you know, the level that these makeup artists are like doing it at. And she's so amazing, you know? So I was like, okay, I'm here, she's here, let's
make it happen.
Let's, you know?
No.
And I need a new pair of lashes, so I'm stealing them.
Absolutely amazing. And yeah, I'm so happy that Khosi is the person who chose you.
Yeah, no, definitely. Definitely.
You're talking them so well.
Yeah.
She did the dance. She did the dance. The dance. Okay, let's get into our first question. I am dying to know, what inspired you or what drove you to explore and experiment with the digital space and, you know, with being a digital entrepreneur? What pushed you? What was that drive?
I think, like, outside of drive, I've just always been someone who enjoys convenience, to be honest, and I always move as the world is moving.
Right.
I think it wasn't necessarily the digital space that I've always seen myself in.
Okay.
It was always fashion, but because the world is moving to that space, I was just like, well, I have to find myself in there and make it self-serving, make that space self-serving as well. So I might say convenience. People like things at their fingertips, people like easy things, people like to be connected easily, and if I can give them that and make a living off of that, then hey, why not?
That's so interesting. Maybe just to expand, or maybe to like hone in on the definition of a digital entrepreneur. Yes. What is that? For someone who's sitting at home, they have an internet connection.
Yes.
And they're following you.
Yeah.
What is a digital entrepreneur?
Simply put, it is someone who makes or runs and operates their business online. A lot of the time, it's so like weird because I'm always like, oh my gosh, you have like a whole office and everything. I literally run my business on my phone. I run my business off of my phone, off of my laptop, and that's what a digital entrepreneur is.
I love that so much.
Amazing.
I love that so much. Maybe then this will help us segue into Hellen Rose.
Okay.
Who is Hellen Rose?
Who, guys?
How did she come about?
Name, age.
My words.
She
sounds like an old woman, like an old English woman. Like a bougie old English woman, yes.
So who is Hellen Rose?
Hellen is my mother.
Oh, I love it already.
Rose is my grandmother.
A stag.
See, now it's got so much more weight.
Oh, yeah.
So much more weight than just
I think, people always like, oh, it's such a sellable name, it's such a global name, but it means more to me than just that.
Yeah.
The intention behind the name was never to sort of just make it sellable I think African is sellable as well.
Absolutely.
We believe in it. It just so happens that the most important women in my life have, are they English names? Whatever, Western names. So my mother's name is Hellen, my grandmother's name is Rose, but I will say my mother's name is Hellen with one L.
Okay.
The double L happened because a homegirl couldn't find, what is it? What do you call it? What is this thing?
A
domain with one L, yes! No, I'm serious, my mom is Hellen with one L. So I was trying to purchase a domain and it was like Hellen with one L Rose is unavailable. And I was like,
so did you have to be Hellen?
So let's just get the two L's. You know?
Hellen.
So that's who Hellen Rose, I guess, is.
Yeah.
How old is she? Hellen Rose is
3 years old?
Yeah, she's 3 years old.
3 years old.
I'll tell you why. Put a pin in that. I'll tell you why. That is wild to me.
So Hellen Rose is 3 years old. What was the other question?
What is her preferred vino?
Who's her preferred vino?
Rich bitch.
Okay.
I'm about it.
I can't.
So what is So what is the platform? Like its sole purpose, its soul, its heart. What is it for?
To relay women's resolves and women's ideas, women's passions. Really, the platform was me trying to get away from, the business end of that, getting away from mainstream blogging, which was self-centered. Well, it still is very self-centered, and would just be about Lerato, where Lerato's going, what Lerato's wearing, what Lerato's eating. And I was just like, there's so many women who don't necessarily want to establish their own platforms, but still want a voice and want platforms that are established, because I kind of believe that I have established myself to give
absolutely
art a platform.
Yeah.
And I was like, how, man, just create this platform and it speaks for itself. It's for women by women. It's ours. It's not mine. It's ours, and women share everything recipes to their personal experiences about certain things to business ideas or business solutions, travel, everything. So I just wanted to bring that together onto one platform.
And is it specifically for women of color?
You know, I actually love that question so much because I really want to say to anyone following or writing for Hellen Rose, my agenda is to push the Black women's agenda forward.
You got it on
but
camera.
But there is a but. My priority is to push the Black women's agenda forward, right. But it is not exclusive to Black women. We have women of all races writing for him. But you will know that I prioritize the Black women's agenda.
Amazing.
Oh, I love that so much. Maybe so. Rewind this morning.
Yes.
When I told Nels that we were going to have Lerato Kgamanyane on the channel, I don't even know how she made it through the day, to be honest. She's like, I'm crying. I'm screaming. I don't know. Oh my God, okay. Pinch me. So, and she.
All the emotions, guys.
She has been just referencing you so much and just following your work and your influence and, you know, just that space and the space that you've cut out and created for yourself for all intents and purposes. So maybe just to people watching, what did that take? Because, you know, people watch and they say, oh, this pretty girl just came on some Instagram account and she's perfect.
Think you just have to be pretty, and I know that's not nearly half
that's
the work.
That's not
nearly
even
half the work.
Yeah.
So, what did that take?
Intention. It took a lot of intention. I'd like to believe I am a woman of intention.
Yeah,
absolutely. I know what I want and I know what it will require for me to get there.
Yeah.
So I have to be intentional with everything I do, or it will fail. You know.
Well.
It took a lot of also just being honest with myself, you know, man.
Get into it, girl.
Yeah, it took a lot of being honest with myself. I think I was always. Listen, I come from a very small family.
Right.
Not a family who was exposed to many opportunities to big things, you know.
Yeah.
So I've always wanted to ensure that I have a sure thing going on for myself, you know. I mean, when I was, you know, a matriculant, I didn't know what I wanted to do with my life. I just knew that I had to do a sure thing, you know. It took a lot of being honest with myself. I mean, I was not going to be, even if I did excel in those careers, I was not going to be happy. I really wasn't going to be happy. It took a lot of soul searching.
Yeah?
It took a lot of soul searching. What else did it take? A lot of risk. I believe I'm fearless. I really do. Hectic or whatever, but listen, you've got nothing to lose.
Yeah.
Just go for it. And
my God.
Shoot your damn shot. And that's in fact how I did penetrate the industry.
Yeah.
You know,
slid into the DMs.
Slid into the DMs. The next thing I have a meeting, and then the next thing, you know, exactly. So,
my God. That's so important, the being fearless part, especially because I think, you know, as Black children, I do think it's something that our parents suppress in us.
Yes.
And not from a selfish point of view. They do it to sort of...
protective.
Yeah, they're protecting us. Because, I mean, how many times can you fall and still get up? But we almost have to keep getting up.
Yeah.
And forging new paths so that, you know, our children and our children's children can move through this world easier. So, in any case, I said we'd put a pin into the fact that Hellen Rose is 3 years old. And if you've been listening to how Lerato speaks, it's because she's only 23. I'm allowed to say that. She's only 23. She's only 23, and there's just such a clarity and, you know, a resolve of purpose and how?
At 23.
I mean, even in matric, just like matriculating and deciding that this is where I want to do. The how, I'll figure it out.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I don't.
Where did it come from? Like,
yeah. Is that something? Is that like that's your mom, your grandma, or.
Jeez, where did it come from?
I'm sorry, we got deep.
Listen, I'm
so quick.
So sorry.
I'm not going to lie to you and like pull out a story or whatever. I don't. Yeah. But I think I had just. I don't know, I'm a very sensitive person, so I'll always be sensitive to my realities and I'll always be sensitive to what I feel, okay. You know, and if in that time my feelings tell me like this is not what you're meant to do, you know, I will listen, you know, I will listen, I guess. I don't know, I honestly do not know where it comes from. I think I'm very fortunate to be able to be someone who can communicate with herself and really choose herself over worldly things. But I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I don't know. I really don't know.
We love the transparency.
It's a blessing, I guess. Yeah, I'll say that. Where it comes from, it's God. It's God. I'm so fortunate to be able to be as young as I am. I don't think I'm young, to be honest. I really have an issue with age.
What is your issue with age?
But yeah, I'm very fortunate to be as young as I am,
yeah.
And to have seen the things that I've seen, yeah. And be able to sort of just recognize what my heart wants. I listen to my heart, so. Yeah, you know, I mean, listen, I'm not a child who, like I said, comes from a family where it's easy to be a child of purpose and to tell your mother, oh, mom, you know, I want to take a two-year gap year, well, two gap years, rather, and go and pursue teaching in Asia or whatever. I don't come from such a family that can allow that. You know, but I think, you know, my mom would always scold me for always being like a child with a plan. She'd always be like, you always say you'll make a plan. Always say. But I always do. I always do, you know, like
I love
always do. I think I always come with solutions. Like if something happens with school, I'll always be like, don't worry, I'll make a plan. Figure it out. And I do. And not so much just for her or for my family, but because I know I need to.
And just learn.
You know, you spoke about intention.
Yeah.
What would you say is the difference between passion and intent or intention?
Or how do they complement?
What is the difference between passion and intention?
What's
the difference between passion and intention? I think passion is something you cannot escape.
Yeah,
it's like, you know,
these
I don't know, chicken licking adverts. If you guys know of the orangutan that catches the eye and it keeps growing, you know, never run away from your passion.
Mm-hmm.
It'll always creep up on you, it'll always fit you. No matter what. You know what I mean? And I think your intention is how you want to apply that or anything in the world, actually.
Yeah.
How you want like I said, apply it
pursue it,
you know. And you asked how do they align?
Yes.
Well, I guess my last answer kind of answers that. So your passion is what will not escape you. What your heart knows is what it wants to do. I think your passion is very much. I don't know, maybe we call it a passion, but I think God speaks on it as a purpose.
Right.
What you're sent to earth to do. Because I don't think God will remove you from the things your heart wants. So I think your passion is probably that. And the intention is how you want to apply it. So that's how they align.
I love it.
I'm just so shook.
Oh my God.
Oh my god, I love it so much.
I love it too.
You're so impressive, and I think it's so important for, like, you know, young black women specifically to articulate these things.
Yeah.
You know, because we all sort of have similar experiences.
Yes.
And we maybe just like murmur amongst ourselves and amongst each other about it. But like to, you know, to actually voice it out, to create a platform like the one that you've created is just
incredible.
It's astoundingly important. Because you create Hellen Rose, someone else is gonna create another platform, and suddenly there's, so I also know that these people who don't believe that there can ever be an oversaturation of
that. No, never.
Right?
Never.
So that's why it's so important, we have to start.
They can
something.
Never.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, no.
With Khosi, but it's always tell her, I gas her up about her makeup skills.
Yeah.
It's like, it's so important. You monetized something people call a hobby to this day. To this day,
it's an actual profession.
And you know, it's so important. And she left a bit. She was telling us on another episode of Say What about how she was living in the US. And while she was gone, there was an article in one of the papers, I can't remember, and they were saying, you know, the next Khosi Shabalala or something. And I was like, that's wild, that reaches crazy to me. Because that's what it means to start something. So thank you.
Thank you so much.
Go on a preach. Go on all day.
Before Lerato goes, we do have like a short list of questions.
Oh, okay, yeah.
We get to the table and it's most asked questions, something like that.
Yeah,
okay. Challenge. Okay, right, so. So we don't want the answer to be very extensive.
Okay,
short. No, brief.
Very short.
First, I can do that.
First thing comes to mind.
Yeah.
Okay.
I can do that.
Perhaps in a word, what were you like in high school?
Rebellious.
Really? I could never have guessed. Number two, are you a hunter or a gatherer? The interpretation is up to you.
What you hunting? What you gathering?
Spicy.
Hunter. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Number three, what are you known for? And although you've already, you know, sort of covered this, mm-hmm. but perhaps in a word.
Maybe what would you be? Well, what would you like to be known for?
Yes.
Remembered for.
Remembered for.
So that's Levis. Oh, like, sorry. We promised it.
No, yeah, and it's like.
She's so inspiring. We're sitting here. We're
sitting here.
What would you like to be remembered for? Yeah.
Being a handful of emancipation woman.
Mm,
yeah.
I love it. What song do you always sing along to?
What song do I always sing along to? Currently, Property by Mr. Easy.
Sing it for me, please.
I love my property. I give you authority. I give you authority. If you go down like economy, baby, you go follow me.
Okay, would you rather someone go through your phone or your internet history?
Shirt dresses.
Shirt dresses.
That was so easy.
Yeah.
But I want to be
No, that's no, not even.
You it's, just.
I love shirt dresses. I just know. Yeah.
Okay. What's a talent you've always wished you had?
I wish I could. Jeez. I wish I could. I don't know.
Wow, you're a chance human being.
No.
Okay.
No.
Yeah.
Okay,
there we go.
Yeah. I be generous. Me, I no go do you wrong. Like Lazarus. Baby, make we go dead.
Now, I'd really love to ask why.
You may.
Yeah, why?
So I always feel like I have anxiety, you know, like I have lots of anxiety. And I think I'd like to, I don't need to go into the past really. I'd like to protect myself from things.
Right.
Things that I haven't seen, things that are going to happen that may sort of either put me in trauma or throw me off my path or whatever, you know what I mean? So I'd like to know what's going to happen that I can protect myself from right now. Absolutely. So no, definitely into the future.
Rasha, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
We can't. We'd love to continue, but we have to share you with everybody. We can't wait to continue this conversation off camera.
Sorry.
What you don't do. Bye. What you don't do is like, comment.
Oh yeah.
And subscribe. Going to be uploading videos more regularly. Thank you so much.
I also just want to say, sorry, while we're all here, whenever you guys feel like compelled to drag, say what, for our absence, guys, I show up for shoots and then I hand over to my digitally able sister. There's nothing I can do once I've shot. And then what I will do, I'll come through with the words, with the literature, on all the social media platforms, I'll gas it. So it's on me, we'll be together. Okay. So it's on
baby, all of my property. All of my property. I give you authority. I give you authority. If you go down like economy, economy. Baby, you go follow me. Follow me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Na money be coco. Oh, ni coco. Your body be coco. Yeah, body be coco. For your sake, I go Walango loco. From Niger, you did this stop so we too.